So every so often, if I have to go and see the administrators or something, it'd always be, oh, you're the one that wants to be the funeral director. Because you know, I was some sort of oddity that everyone had heard about in the office and they all wondered which one it was. A lot of decent, proper funeral directors take a very, you know, treat it as a vocation. I think if you just see it as a job, you're probably not a very good funeral director. It's no place for 9-to-5ers. You can be an adequate funeral director, but that's all you ever will be if you think like that. I have a Christian faith, and I think I probably had that before I started work. And I don't necessarily think that my work has strengthened or weakened that belief. I've never actually encountered anything which would make me believe in life after death or anything like that. In my first few years in the profession, I was itching to see everything I could. I had quite a sort of a morbid wish list in my mind, and I can vividly remember my first railway suicide, my first murder, my first road accident, because, you know, when you're a funeral director, that's what you do. And so I was fascinated to see what it would be like and how you deal with something like that. I think the thing that struck me most, certainly when I dealt with my first railway fatality, part of me was thinking, well, I was fascinated to know how you actually deal with it and how they closed the railway line and how we had to do what we had to do. But the other thing that struck me was, I think I was expecting something of almost sort of comic book grisliness. And what actually stuck in my mind more than anything else, and I was only 16 at the time when I went to my first railway scene, was how pathetic the person looked. I never really understood what the word pathetic meant until I saw that lady lying there, and I thought, gosh, that's, you know, that was a human being, and I was still a human being, but an hour or two before, that was someone who was up and about and wandering around, and albeit had made the decision to take her own life. But there is something uniquely pathetic sometimes about dead bodies, particularly with sudden death. But there was one gentleman, I happened to be in the funeral home of my employer, and his second in command had gone out to do a house removal, and they brought this chap back, and he died of cancer. And he wasn't wearing much clothing, he was sort of half naked. And he was very, very badly jaundiced. Poor chap really was bright yellow, just from the jaundice. And I went a little bit weak at the knees, and I had to leave the room for a few moments because I found that a bit challenging. But when someone dies, the heart stops pumping, the circulation stops, and the blood will gravitate to the lowest point of the body, which is why 99 times out of 100 people die lying down. And that's why people have this idea of people looking very pale and sunken. It's because the heart's not working anymore, so the blood just gravitates away from the face. So embalming fluid is designed to have a preservative element, a sanitizing element to it, and also to mimic the action of the blood by having coloured dyes within it to restore a slightly more natural colour. British embalmers are very much of the view that less is more, and so the only time, unless the family specifically say to us, look, we'd like mother to wear a full set of makeup or something, the cosmetology is really confined to what we call technical cosmetology. So for example, if there's bruising or grazing or something which needs to be covered, just to try and restore a slightly more natural appearance. Prospect of my own death scares me a bit. Being dead doesn't bother me, but I'm not morbid about it, but you know, you do think, especially when you go on longer car journeys and things, you think, well, all the people I've seen that have died in accidents all thought they were going to come home that night and they didn't. I'm convinced, and I hope, that there is something beyond the mortal coil, because I see an awful lot of life. When you're working with death, you see an awful lot of life.